Thank you. In the most holy name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, we give praise and thanks to Allah for his love and his mercy upon humanity, always giving us guidance through his prophets and his messengers, among them Moses with the Torah, Jesus with the gospel, Muhammad ibn Abdullah with the Holy Quran. I can never thank Allah enough for his intervention in our affairs in the person of Master Farad Muhammad, God in person, the great Mahdi, who came here July 4th, 1930. He met, and it was written that he would meet, one who was a grandson of slaves. That one he met face to face and was with for 3.5 years, night and day. And when he left here, he had left with him a wisdom that is called supreme wisdom, because it is a wisdom that has not been known for 66 trillion years. That one that he deposited that wisdom in rose to be the most powerful man ever to walk this planet, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And now we know him to be the Messiah, the Christ that is written of in Scripture. He had a student, one from among the class, whom he deposited in a knowledge, wisdom, and guidance. And that man had a heart so pure and full of love for you and I that he now carries among us and throughout the world the will of Allah in real time, the active will and the guidance directly from Allah. And that man is the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. In those names, I greet all of my brothers and sisters here at Mosque Mariam and on webcasts in the words of peace of Assalamu Alaikum. It is always such an overwhelming honor to be able to stand before you at Mosque Mariam. Even to be in this edifice is a very powerful experience. I had the honor of being part of a small delegation from the Nation of Islam to visit St. Sabina Church here in Chicago last Sunday. Father Michael Flager, who I call the Farrakhan of the Catholic Church, a very beautiful man with a beautiful spirit, who the Honorable Elijah, Honorable Minister Farrakhan calls my brother. And he is an activist. He is a man that loves the people of the community. And last Sunday, the guest speaker was Elder Bernice King, the daughter of Martin Luther King Jr. And as I listened to her, I thought about Minister Farrakhan teaching us that we have the ability to escape death and to escape time when we line up our heart and mind with the will of God. And as I listened to Bernice King, I thought about what I'm going to be talking about today and what I had talked about a few weeks prior, and that is the final obstructions to freedom. And Elder King was very firm, very clear in her condemnation of those Negroes who benefited not only from the work of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, but she talked about the work of her father and how so many who are in corporate America and government and even President Barack Obama are there because of the sacrifice of those who came before them, who were willing to lay down, and in many cases did lay down their lives, that we may move forward in this nation. I have never heard a woman speak so straight in the church. And I thought to myself, Minister Farrakhan is so right. Martin Luther King Jr. is still preaching more than 40 years after his death through his daughter. And all praise is due to Allah. Today is part two and the final part of the final obstruction to freedom. I want to read from Surah 57 in the 57th year since Minister Farrakhan came into the Nation of Islam as we prepare to celebrate the birth of Master Farrad Muhammad, February 26, 1877. Now, Surah 57, Al-Hadid, iron. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, whatever is in the heavens and the earth declares the glory of Allah, and He is the Mighty, the Wise. His is the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. He gives life and causes death, and He is the possessor of power over all things. He is the first and the last, and the manifest and the hidden, and He is knower of all things. He it is who created the heavens and the earth in six periods, and He is established on the throne of power. He knows that which comes forth out of it, goes down into the earth, and He knows that which comes forth out of it, and that which comes down from heaven, and that which goes up to it. And He is with you wherever you are, and Allah is seer of what you do. His is the kingdom of the heavens and the earth, and to Allah are all affairs returned. He causes the night to pass into the day, and causes the day to pass into the night. And He is knower of what is in the hearts. Believe in Allah and His messenger, and spend of that whereof He has made you heirs. So those of you who believe and spend, for them is a great reward. And what reason have you that you believe not in Allah? And the messenger invites you to believe in your Lord, and He has indeed accepted your covenant if you are believers. He it is who sends down clear messages to His servant that He may bring you forth from darkness into light. And surely Allah is kind, merciful to you. And what reason have you that you spend not in Allah's way? And Allah's is the inheritance of the heavens and the earth. Those of you who spent before the victory and fought are not on a level with others. They are greater in rank than those who spent and fought afterwards. And Allah has promised good to all, and Allah is aware of what you do. So, beloved, in that first section, we are given the mighty attributes, many of them. He has 99 divine attributes. But that section is to relieve us of fear and relieve us of any doubt that the righteous will be the victor. Now later, in another section, he moves into the reality that truth will be established. And in verse 25, it reads, "Certainly, we sent our messengers with clear arguments and sent down with them the book and the measure, that men may conduct themselves with equity. And we sent down iron, wherein is great violence and advantages to men, and that Allah may know who helps him and his messengers unseen. Surely Allah is strong, mighty." And so, beloved, that verse which the surah is named after, iron, Allah said, we sent down iron, wherein there are two things, violence and great advantages. Now, iron is a chemical element. It is the most common element by mass forming this planet, Earth. Much of the outer and inner core of Earth is iron. It is also the core of Moon. Iron is the fourth most common element in this solar system. We sent down iron. So iron is rooted in what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad refers to as the lower heavens, in that it is abundant in its production. Iron is actually the result of the fusion of supernova, or huge stars, which produce nickel, which in turn decays or settles into iron. Iron is the last element to be produced before collapse of a supernova. And of all the metals that exist on this planet, none has been proven to be of greater usefulness. And yet Allah revealed these verses 1,400 years ago, prior to the manifestation of the complete use of iron, from which steel is made. It's used for tools, and it's used for weapons of war. Now, he says great violence. If you go in the Bible, you can't even get through the fourth chapter of Genesis before there's violence. And violence is also accompanied by a reference to iron. Genesis chapter 4 is where Cain, the son of Adam and Eve, murders his brother, Abel. Now, Cain has a great-great-grandson named Tubal-Cain, who is described in Genesis 4:22 as a teacher and instructor in the use of brass and iron. And Tubal-Cain's father, Cain's great-great-grandson Lamech, kills a man right in verse 23. According to the translator, Maulana Muhammad Ali, this surah gets its name for its reference to the punishment of the opponents who were bent upon extirpating Islam with the sword. And when you read that entire surah, you will see that. Extirpate, this is what the translator describes it as. Well, to extirpate, beloved, means you pull something up by its roots. You exterminate it. You remove it. You destroy it completely. So why does this matter to the black man and woman in America in 2012? Because Islam, whether you have come yet to accept it, is your religion. It is your way of life. It is your nature. It is the nature of the Creator and the nature in which He created the universe. As I stand here, it is the active policy of the United States government under the Obama administration to extirpate or uproot and completely destroy Islam.